So we're back trying another video tag, and this one is the Taylor Swift tag. Both of us are really big Taylor Swift fans and reading fans, so when you combine the two, it just makes it like perfect. So let's get started. The first question of the tag is related to the song We Are Never Ever Getting Back Together. And what the question is what is a book that you thought you loved, but actually ended up hating in the end? And this book for me was Inked Up by Cornelia Funke. I love the first two books in the series, and I begged and begged to get this book and to buy it, because for like a 13-year-old, a $30 book is pretty expensive. So when I got it,
that's expensive.
Right? So when I bought it, I was like, oh my god, I'm gonna love it, and I didn't.
Mine was actually the first one in the Ink Death series, Inkheart. I think my niece personally picked it out for my birthday present when I was like 14. And I think I got 50 pages in, and I don't know what happened. I don't like it. I don't know. I can't even think of a reason. I think I just wasn't really connecting with it, so I never finished it.
The next song is Love Story, and the question related is pick a book with forbidden love in it. And the book I picked was The Daughter of Smoke and Bone. Still just the dust jacket, though. Sorry.
Mine was Matt because of Cotton Cassia, because, like, you know, obviously, if you read the book, yeah.
The next one was I Knew You Were Trouble, which is the character that's bad, but you couldn't help but love them. Warner had my heart from the first book, and I just love him, and this book was just perfect.
Mine was Eric Northman from the Slicky Stackhouse series, because, like, bad boys that can protect me. I'm sorry, I can't help myself.
So, the next question is Innocent, a book that someone ruined the ending to for you. Mine is Allegiant.
It's not my fault you guessed right.
The person who ruined the ending to Allegiant is actually sitting right next to me. We were in Walmart, and I made a comment, and she gave me a hint that ruined the entire ending.
Okay, look, bitch. Mine was Walk to Remember, just because, like, no one's actually personally ruined it for me, but because it's a movie, everyone's like, oh my god, this happens, and I'm like, thanks.
The next song is Everything Has Changed, which is pick a book that the main character has gone through extensive character development. And I picked The Deathly Hallows because of Ron Weasley in this book. Because he ends up leaving the camp and he comes back and he's like stronger and he learns that how to survive and like that he doesn't have to be the golden boy to get love. And I just enjoyed Ron, and he kind of got over the whole jealousy thing.
I picked Allegiant because I don't think Triss would have done what she did in the end. From like the middle of the book, I don't think she would have made the same choice, which I think is cool.
The next song is You Belong With Me, which is what is your most anticipated release of 2015? This is easy for me. That's Lady Midnight by Cassandra Clare. I want to continue on the Shadowhunter world. I miss being there, and I want to go back to it.
I don't have one for 2015 because I don't really follow books like that, but I had one single one for 2014, which was In the Afterlight, because I read the first two, like, in, I think, a 3 or 4 day span up at college. And I was like, okay, time to buy the last one and finish it, and it didn't come out for 2 weeks. And it was the worst 2 weeks of my life, and I pre-ordered it and everything, and as soon as it, like, released, I know I could just download it.
And the last one is Come Back, Be Here. What's a book that you don't want to lend out for fear of missing it too much? Mine is, I have like a couple books or series that I don't lend out to anyone because those are my babies, but one of the biggest ones is Nora Roberts' The Blood Brothers trilogy. It's one of my favorite books of all time, and I won't even lend it out to this one here because I love these books so much.
Mine is The Fault in Our Stars, not because of the book itself, but at home I have a signed copy, and that's not going anywhere besides my bookshelf or my hands.
So yeah, guys, that's the Taylor Swift book tag. I enjoyed making this tag. It's actually one of my favorites to watch on YouTube, so I wanted to make it myself. I'm really excited about it, and I hope you guys are too. See you next time, guys. Bye.